Hello children,
I hope all of you are doing well. Today we are going to start another topic of the chapter life processes, that is transportation. In previous module we have discussed about the digestion, respiration. In that we got to know for the maintenance of the life we need food, and the breakdown of that food is done with the help of oxygen that we take during the process of respiration. Now point is this: if the cells are having the oxygen, they need energy. How the cells get that energy or oxygen? So for that there is a need of any transport. So when we talk about the any transport in case of organism, that transport is actually your circulatory system, especially in case of human beings. So here we are talking about that one important life process, transportation. So if we talk about the transportation in human beings, so that time there is a need of a very complex system, a very complex transport system to carry oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrient, waste product, food and various other substances from one part of the body to the another part of the body. And for that there is a need of well-defined system, and in case of human beings we call that system as a circulatory system. Now if we talk about the simple organism, in simple organism that system is not so well defined. The transport may be take place just through the diffusion. Children, make it very sure, you should remember that if we talk about a simple organism or very lower organism, that time in case of that transport is done by just a simple process that we call as a diffusion. But when we talk about the human beings or the higher organism, that time there is a need of a well-defined system. And in case of human beings, we call that system as a circulatory system. So if we want to know the circulatory system in human beings, we should know the component of the circulatory system. Means how we are taking, how the every cell is taking the oxygen, how they are taking the nutrients, by what pathway it is coming to every cell. So for that there is a coordination of different organ, and that organ together make a system that we call as a circulatory system. Now in this case of human being, what we can see, in this chart, that is what circulatory system in human being is having. How many things they have? One pumping organ that we call as a heart. They have a blood and blood vessels, that is the arteries and veins. Along with the arteries and veins, they have another kind of blood vessels that we call as a capillaries. Children, please remember it. Human is having a, or the higher organism is having a three kind of blood vessels: arteries, veins and capillaries. So arteries, you know very well, the arteries carry the pure blood, means oxygen is going through the every cell of the body through the arteries, and veins is carrying the carbon dioxide, right? So exchange of the oxygen and carbon dioxide is done with another kind of blood vessels that connect the arteries and veins, that we know as a capillaries. Now what is flowing in this? Who is taking that oxygen? Who is carrying that oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrient and other harmful and useful substance, that are the blood. So blood is what? Blood is another fluid connective tissue, and it is having a different things. By that oxygen and carbon dioxide is combining. Another component of the circulatory system is lymph. So how many things is present in a human circulatory system? A pumping organ, blood vessels, blood and lymph. So here I have shown you one of the flow chart, that is the circulation of the blood take place through the human heart. So that we will discuss in the coming module. So what is blood? Blood is the first component of a human circulatory system. Blood is a fluid connective tissue. It is red in color and it circulates all over the body. Blood is supplying nutrients, oxygen to all living cells and collect the waste product and carbon dioxide to be thrown out of the body. So this is the important work of the blood. If you see the composition of the blood, blood is having a what? Blood is having a plasma and blood cells, one of the important thing. What is the composition? What percentage of plasma is present in the blood? What percentage of the blood cell is making the blood? So that we will discuss in coming slide. Composition of blood and its function. If you talk about the composition of blood, blood is, I told you as, blood is made up of plasma and blood cells. If you talk about the percentage of the plasma is 55% and the blood cells is having a 45%. Now, if we talk about the plasma, plasma is one of the important fluid that present in the blood. It is having a water, salts, protein, and important proteins, for example, globulin, fibrinogen. Fibrinogen is one of the important protein that help in clotting of blood. Please kids, remember it. Fibrinogen is one of the important protein present in the plasma of the blood that help in clotting of the blood. Other than that, 45% is the blood cell. If you talk about the blood cells, how many type of blood cell present in the blood? So that time, if you talk about the blood cell is RBC, WBC and platelets. RBC is how many numbers? That is a 5 to 6 million RBCs per ml of the blood. It is meant for the transport of oxygen and carbon dioxide. As you know from your respiratory process, oxygen is more soluble in RBC in comparison to the carbon dioxide. Next blood cell is the white blood cells. It is having a 5000 to 10000 per ml of the blood. They play very important role in immunity and defense. So it includes three type of cell. Lymphocyte, macrophages and granulocytes. Lymphocytes again T and B cells, they are meant for the formation of antibodies. Macrophages, phagocyte in nature means whenever the any infection, any pathogen come in the blood, that time it is eaten or phagocyte by these cells that we call as a macrophages. Where it is present in the WBC of the blood. Granulocytes, again neutrophils, basophils, eosinophils, these are for the inflammation of the cell, these provide the anti-allergy. So these are the different functions that are done by the RBC of the WBCs of the blood cells. Another important blood cell is known as the platelets. These are the very important blood cells that help in clotting of the blood. So these are the three type of blood cell basically present in the plasma of the blood. If we talk about the function, basically the function of the blood is the transport of the oxygen. They deliver oxygen wherever they are deliver the oxygen. They pick up the carbon dioxide and waste and transport. They along with that they transport hormones and nutrients. As you know, WBCs play important role in immunity. So what is the again important function of the blood is that defense, because whenever the any pathogen attack on your body or through the blood, that time blood participate as a formation of defense, right? Blood also help in the maintenance of the body temperature, and water, iron, salt also maintained by the blood. So when this water salt maintain is done by the blood, so that time we call it as a homeostasis. A very important word, homeostasis, means maintain the ionic balance and the temperature of the body. So these are the important functions of the blood, and due to that it is a very important part of the human circulatory system. A very important blood cell that you know, platelets. What is the role of platelet? What are platelets? So platelets are what? These are the cells that are lacking a nucleus, and from where they are derived? They are derived from the bone marrow, play a very important role in blood clotting. So actually what happens whenever there is, in case of any injury, when bleeding occurs, loss of blood from the system has to be minimized, right? So leakage leads to a loss of pressure, which reduces the efficiency of pumping system. To prevent that, blood has platelets. So that is an important role of platelets to prevent that blood has a platelet cell which circulate around the body and form a mesh like structure or mesh like network or clot at the site of injury. So this is the important function of the platelets. Very important to play a crucial role in a blood clotting. Now you can see in this diagram also what happens. They break open when they come in the contact with the sharp edges of a broken blood vessels and release chemicals which begin the blood clotting. There is a one word is given. This is a fibrin. I have told you when I was saying about the important proteins present in the plasma, one of the important protein that was a fibrinogen. So what happens whenever there is a platelets performing or helping the process of clotting, in that time fibrinogen actually change into this fibrin gel, and due to this fibrin gel blood stop bleeding. So this is the important function of the platelets. Another type of fluid that participate in the process of transportation is lymph. So what is lymph? Lymph is another fluid that involved in the transportation, and it flows through a vessel that we call as a lymphatic vessels, just like the blood vessels. And as you know, blood vessels, all the blood vessels open into a common vessels. Same with the lymphatic vessels also. Lymphatic capillaries join to the lymphatic vessels and finally they open into a large veins. If you talk about the function of the lymph, so what is the important function of the lymph? As you know from the digestion, what happens in the digestion? If you remember, from the wall of a small intestine, there is an absorption of the soluble food, right? Means carbohydrate, protein, fat, all the soluble form of the food absorbed through the wall of intestine. Why? Because from the wall of intestine, there is a presence of a blood vessels. So especially I want to mention at this point, in that case, carbohydrate and protein is transported through the blood vessels present in the wall of a small intestine. But when we talk about the absorption of the digested fat, in that case, there is a presence of a lymphatic vessels or lymph vessels that is having a fluid that we call as a lymph, and through that there is a absorption of fat take place and it going to the different parts of the cell, different parts of our body, wherever it is needed. How the lymph formation take place? So this is a very simple thing when we talk about that, the how does lymph form. So lymph form whenever there is a, you know, there is a two type of vessels, arteries and veins. Whenever there is a exchange of substance, exchange is taking place between the arteries and veins. So I have told you there is a presence of capillaries, and these capillaries is having a pores, intercellular pores are present, and through the pores there is a leakage of the fluid, and that fluid is having a blood cells, plasma, protein, salts, and that comes from that pores and into the intercellular space between the blood capillaries. So that that filtered fluid, you can say, is the lymph. Very important, you should remember that lymph is similar to plasma of blood, but it is colorless and contain less protein. So this is very important, you should remember about the lymph. And now what is the difference if we're talking about the lymph and blood? So both of them, fluid that participate in the process of transportation. So there must be a certain differences between the lymph and blood regarding their function, regarding their composition. So what is the difference between the blood and lymph? If we talk about the difference, so blood is reddish in color. Why it is? Because there is a presence of the RBC. In case of lymph, they are not having RBC cells, so that's why they are pale yellow in color. So RBCs are present in blood and RBCs are absent in lymph. If you talk about the blood, blood is bidirectional, means it can go up and low in both sides. But when we talk about the lymph, lymph is always unidirectional in flow. In blood, flow is very rapid. In case of lymph, it is very slow. If you talk about the blood, blood is having a very less number of leukocyte in case of lymph. It is having a high number. That's why principal function of the lymph is for the immunity. They participate in the immune system to accelerate your immune system in your body. Platelets are present in the blood and platelets are absent in the blood. It means lymph doesn't participate in the process of clotting. So these are the certain few differences that I have discussed between the blood and blood and lymph. So this is all about your the one of the composition of the transport system that we call as the blood. In the next video, we will discuss about the human structure, the functioning of the human structure. So what are the different structure present in the chordates? Is there any difference? Why there is a difference? So that we will discuss in the coming video. And I hope whatever I have told you, you will get to know very easily. You will connect it. If we have any issues, then we will discuss also. So we will meet very soon in the coming video. Thank you.